In order to understand the risk that NSAIDs pose to the kidneys, it is critical to understand kidney hemodynamics, the pressure and flow of blood through the kidney. Each kidney is made up of about 1 million filtering units called nephrons. The glomerulus is the portion of the nephron where filtering takes place. Blood flows into each glomerulus via an afferent arteriole and out via an efferent arteriole. The tone of these arterioles alters the pressure within each glomerulus and regulates filtration. In other words, the relative vasoconstriction or vasodilation of the afferent and efferent arterioles determines the pressure within each glomerulus, and it is that pressure that pushes fluids and small molecules out of the capillary and into the tubular lumen of the nephron. The renin-angiotensin system is activated by decreased blood flow to the kidney. The resultant rise in angiotensin II constricts the efferent arteriole and raises the glomerular capillary pressure and maintains glomerular filtration rate. Renin-angiotensin system blockers, such as ACE inhibitors and angiotensin receptor blockers, block this action and lower glomerular capillary pressure. This may be protective in chronic kidney disease, especially diabetes. However, in states of volume loss and decreased kidney perfusion, such as congestive heart failure, trauma, cirrhosis, acute volume depletion, or acute gastroenteritis, the use of these drugs may decrease glomerular pressure and GFR. In these same states of volume depletion, prostaglandins may preserve kidney perfusion and GFR by dilating the afferent arteriole. However, NSAIDs block this protective action of prostaglandins and may also decrease glomerular pressure and GFR. Together, the use of NSAIDs and renin-angiotensin system blockers may result in both afferent vasoconstriction and efferent vasodilation and lead to a dramatic decrease in glomerular pressure and GFR, causing acute kidney injury.